एंड गुड मॉर्निंग. आई यश घनशानी वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ क्लास 9th मैथमेटिक्स. इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डेल्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 1.1 ऑफ क्लास 9th मैथमेटिक्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 1.2. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच वी आर गोइंग टू सी इज ट्रू फॉल्स. एवरी इर्रेशनल नंबर इज रियल नंबर. ओके, सो दिस इज ट्रू. Since real number are combination of whole number, natural number, rational, irrational, every number is included in real numbers. So this answer is true, that every irrational number is a real number. The second question, every point on a number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. Okay, so every number, we can't say that every number is in the form of root m, because in the number line we have negative numbers too. So this is false. Third one is, every real number is irrational. As I have told you during this first question, that real number are combination of whole numbers and whole numbers, natural numbers. So every real number can't be irrational. Okay, because we have rational number 2 in real numbers. Now let us move with question number 2. Are the roots of all positive integers irrational? So answer to this question is also no. Roots of all positive integers are not irrational, because root of square root 4 is 2, root of square root 9 is 3, root of 16 is 4. Okay, rather we have root 2 as irrational, root 3 as irrational, but there are certain numbers whose square root is rational. Okay, now the third and the most important question of this exercise is, how we can represent root 5 on a number line. See, representation of square roots on number line is mostly asked in the examination paper. So let us start. I would be making and dictating you the steps of constructions, so you please keep on writing them. Okay, so we have to plot root 5 on a number line. For plotting root 5 on a number line, what we have to do, we have to draw a line AB of 5 units. Okay, and then we have to extend one more unit to C. Firstly, we have to plot root 5, so we will draw AB of 5 units, then increase or extend it 1 unit. Okay, then what we have to do, we have to find the geometric center of AC. We have to find the geometric center of AC. What we are going to do, then how we can take a compass of any radius, from C draw an arc upwards, similarly draw an arc downwards from C. Okay, then repeat this similar process from A. Draw an arc from A, both upwards and of any radius. Okay, then what you have to do, we have to just draw a dotted line joining both these points. Okay, what we have to do, we have to draw a dotted line joining both these points. So this point where this line intersect AC is the geometric center. Okay, is the geometric center of AC. Okay, then what you would do, see, take place the needle here and the pencil here. Okay, measure this and draw a circle. Okay, draw a circle, this semicircle, and this will intersect here at C. Okay, this is because O is the geometric center, so OA and OC would be equal. Okay, now after drawing this semicircle, draw a line perpendicular to this AC from B, which intersect this semicircle. Okay, draw a line perpendicular from B to AC, which intersect this semicircle. And what you have to do, see, now again place the needle of compass here and the pencil here, and draw a circle such that it falls down. Draw an arc which falls down on this line. Okay, draw an arc which falls down on this line, and this point would be your square root 5, and this point would be your square root 5, okay, and this point would be your square root 5. So this is how we can draw any natural number or any number on a number line. For example, in our next exercise, we are having a question to plot square root 9.3. To plot square root 9.3 on a number line. So what you would do, instead of drawing AB of 5 units, we would be drawing AB of 9.3 units. Okay, 9.3 units. And extend B to C of 1 unit. Similarly, find the geometric center by drawing two arcs, one from A and one from C, on both upwards and downwards. Draw a straight line perpendicular, we would find this geometric center. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to just measure this and draw an arc from O such that it forms a semicircle and intersects from A to C. Okay, then what you have to do, you have to draw just a perpendicular from B such that it intersects the semicircle, and mark this point as E. Now measure BE and draw an arc such that it intersects this line, and the point where it intersects would be your square root 9.3. Okay, I hope the method was clear to you. Now you can form the steps of construction from your own. Okay, that draw a line AB of 9.3 unit, extend B to C of 1 unit, find the geometric center of AC, draw a semicircle such that from A to C, then draw a perpendicular from B such that it intersects the semicircle. Okay, and then name the point as E, measure BE and cut an arc such that it intersects its line, and this point would be your required point on the number line. Okay, I hope you find this video helpful, and in my next video we would be discussing how we can draw the square root spiral. It is our next question number 4. Do like and share my video. If you have any doubt, you can mention in the comment section below, and do subscribe my channel, press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you.